And ready to match the stars, Clifton Davis, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Hattie Duke Aston, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Buliffont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Ragger.
Wilson and friends. You brought some feathers and everything, eh? Thank you very much. I just want to extend a word of greeting to you and to each of our regulars in order. Pretty Brett Summers here. And Charles N. Riley. No, he's a very handsome fellow. And Richard Dawson, our third regular. Now,
control yourselves.
The others have all been here. And we try and get them as off as we can. Clifton Davis.
He's lovely.
You got a whole clack out there.
That's my 14 brothers and sisters, yeah.
Teeny boppers.
Look at her with their feathers, aren't
you? Oh, yes, this
you?
Is my marketing dress. You know, I do a lot of
Oh, you go to the, AMP or whatever the equivalent is out here?
Mm-hmm. Patty, what are you shopping for when you wear that, honey?
Where is that? Patty Duke Aston and... Now, you got the flu, haven't you?
I don't want to make you sick.
I'll kiss you anyway.
You will?
Yeah.
You'll be
fine. Hope you feel better, Joyce, dear girl. Joyce Buliffont. Now, let's say hello to our two players over here, Cheryl Betters and Gary Check. Hello! Now, we want to find out a little something about each of you. Gary, we'll begin with you.
I'm from Flint, Michigan, and I was here 2 years singing with a group called Young Americans. I went back to Michigan for
You're a singer?
Yeah.
Oh.
Went back to Michigan for school for 6 months, and I just returned 6 weeks ago, where I'm now a singing waiter down in Southern California, hoping someday to have a career in performance in musical theater.
What, are you a baritone?
Baritone, yep.
Now, Cheryl, about you.
Okay, I'm from Connellsville, Pennsylvania.
Yeah?
I attended the University of Georgia, but since I've come out here, I'm thinking on moving out here.
Should we ask her to move out here?
When are you moving?
Yeah, move out here. You'll love it.
And where are you moving?
That's enough of that. Cut that out now. Good luck to both of you. May I remind you that you'll be trying to match as many of our celebrities as you can. The winner will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. Now, Gary, we'll ask you to make a selection. You want A or B?
A, please.
A it is. We're off and running. Hey, listen, nobody knows this, but Adam and Eve were not alone in the Garden of Eden. No. Once a week, a man came in to blank their fig leaves.
I got it.
Adam and Eve were not alone in the Garden of Eden. Once a week, a man came in to blank their fig leaves.
Don't you love him?
No fighting, children. No fighting, children.
He's got more bloody nerve. Okay.
All right. Clifton is writing his answer. I shall slowly walk over to Gary Check. Now, by the time I finish walking over here, Clifton will have finished and put it in the card. Right? Right. Okay, Gary. Nobody knows this, but Adam and Eve were not alone in the Garden of Eden. Once a week, a man came in to blank their fig leaves.
Wash
their fig leaves. No starch, please. Okay, Clifton. He said, wash the fig leaves.
Yeah, and once a week, the man came in. He had press clean. I think that may be washed too, right?
Press or clean?
Clean.
Press or clean. Now, wait, I got to think about that one. That's a hard one.
Good. That's what I meant.
Clean and press fig leaves. What do you say?
You know what? All the pictures I saw of Adam and Eve, they always looked like they were there forever.
Yeah.
That they were just glued on. It never occurred to me that they could be taken off and cleaned. I thought he just came in and just trimmed them a little
bit. Did they grow? Was that it? They continued?
Sure,
to...
they were fine.
Oh, yes, sir. Of course, yeah. Charles.
Same idea. Clip.
Clip your fig leaf. Okay. Now, Gary's looking for the answer. Once a week, a man came in to wash their fig leaves or clean their fig leaves. What do you say, Patty Duke asked him?
You ought to dust them.
Dust them. Close, but not washing. Now, Richard, give us the definitive answer.
Fish.
Fish. Beautiful answer. You're ashamed of your answer.
Oh, of course I'm not.
Oh! Now, before she shows it, I know she's ashamed of it there.
I beg your pardon? I'm not that ashamed of it.
Your answer,
show. Oh, my answer. Oh, well, he had to do this very carefully, the guy who came in.
Really? Why?
Yeah.
What was it?
He pruned them.
He pruned them, naturally.
What was that?
Yeah, of course. So that's two for you. Not bad for the first round. The first round ones are hard. They're kind of wide open. Listen carefully, Cheryl. This is your old man Periwinkle said,
Surgeon General has issued a special warning to old people. For anyone over 100 years of age, blanking is hazardous to your health.
Surgeon General.
The Surgeon General has issued a special warning. For anyone over 100 years of age, blanking is hazardous to your health.
Goes crazy, you know. He's a wonderful little boy. That's better. Oh, much
okay,
better.
Okay, here we go. Cheryl Betters, are you ready?
Yeah.
Old man Periwinkle said,
the Surgeon General has issued a special warning to old people. For anyone over 100 years of age, blanking is hazardous to your health.
Only thing I can think of, breathing?
Breathing.
To your health, Jean.
Yeah.
Breathing is essential.
Be charitable.
I thought
she may be a loser.
I know they're not going to say the one I thought of, so.
Yeah, oh, I see. All right. All right, what do you say?
I say I hope she was thinking of what I was thinking of.
Just show your card. That's all we ask. A simple answer.
Well, breathing, huh?
Breathing.
Cheryl Betters, better change it to worse. Making love, I said.
Making love.
Well, you should have said that.
You can say that. There's nothing wrong with that, Cheryl. As a matter of fact, Brett, I bet you said it.
Well, honey, after our trip to Encino, I don't even believe it's hazardous. I said making love.
Driving there is the hazardous part there, Charles.
Well, making love and breathing is almost a match.
No.
Heavy.
What if you wrote breathing hard?
Breathing hard?
Making whoopee.
Hey, spelling doesn't count here, but you did have making whoopee there, and you know, I don't know.
We're going to get letters again.
Oh, no. Spelled W-H-O-P-P-I-E. And whoopee is W-H-O-O-P-I-E. Yes, ma'am. Hello there.
You're never going to believe this.
P-E-E, right.
And I don't know why, but I said breathing.
Oh, look at that, Cheryl.
Now, how could the two of us come up with something so silly?
The two of you are weirdos. That's why you came up with the same answer.
That is really strange.
What do you say?
The real answer, of course, is breathing.
Yes.
I said loving.
Loving. Yeah. Okay, she's looking for breathing.
Mr. and Mrs. Periwinkle, right? They were sitting on their... Is that his name?
Old man Periwinkle.
Yeah, I heard a story about them. They were on their first date. They were in the front seat of the car, and they were making out. And
yes.
They were necking and kissing, and he said, you want to get in the back seat? And she said, no. And he said... They started again and got really, real. The windows were getting steamed up, and she said, "Do you want to get in the back seat now?" And she said, "No." And they went on. I mean, they just carried away. And he said, "You want to get in the back seat now?" And he said, she said to him, "No, I want to stay up here with you."
Necking. Well, there we are. We got a game going here, and it'll be a good one. 2-1 is the score, and we'll continue with round 2 in a moment or so. But first, this. Hello there. Round two coming up. Are you ready? There it is. Gary, you're ahead. We'll ask you to go first. A or B?
I'm going to stick with A.
A it is. Let's see. Clifton does not play and Richard does not play. The rest of you, if you would, please respond to this. Tight-lipped Tina never opens her mouth.
Tight-lipped Tina?
Tight-lipped Tina never opens her mouth. So, when Tina got tonsillitis, the doctor had to remove her tonsils through her blank. Oh. Okay. You haven't finished yet.
I just can't imagine. I know it. I
wouldn't
know
open
it.
Her mouth, so you removed her tonsils through her.
Right. Oh, thank you.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that. Now we come over here to Gary. Tight-lipped Tina never opens her mouth, so when Tina got tonsillitis, the doctor had to remove her tonsils through her blank.
Her nose.
Nose is a perfectly good answer. He came up with a marvelous answer. What do you say, Brett, old girl?
I say let's go to Encino right now.
No, stop that. I know you're wearing red and it's inflammatory, and I do want you, but remember.
I know. And Helen's in town.
Yes.
It's depressing. What'd he say?
He said nose.
What on earth would he say nose for?
Because you said nose. There's a match. Oh, you. Charles.
I even knew the doctor knows, and this is an actual x-ray.
Oh, I don't want to see that. All right. Gary's looking for the answer, nose. Patty, what do you say? Nose! Hey, you got five noses so far.
Can I have that key back?
Yeah, all right. Now,
hi.
I wouldn't be too optimistic about getting a match out of Joyce. You know. She's cute.
But not bright. No, I thought this was very good. Wait a minute, who did that? I thought this was logical.
Yeah?
An ear, nose, and throat man would either be the nose or the ear, and I happened to pick the ear.
Oh, well, that's okay. That was one of the good answers. It's a good answer.
Thank you.
It didn't match Gary, but she did come up with a good answer. There is hope for her. And you, for you, you got a match 4-tie, 5-win. Are you ready?
Yep.
Listen carefully. Everyone except Patty, at the camp out, Sally the Girl Scout forgot to bring firewood. So, she tossed her blank onto the fire. At the cookout, Sally the Girl Scout forgot to bring a camp out. She forgot to bring firewood, so she tossed her blank onto the fire.
Girl Scout?
Yes.
Girl Scouts.
They were out at a big camp out. A whole bunch of Girl Scouts there. And Sally, who was in charge of the firewood, forgot to bring it, so she tossed her blank onto the fire.
Clifton isn't finished, and Charles isn't finished.
You really are a lefty, aren't you?
Lefty, left and
okay,
left
all right. Here we go, Cheryl. At the camp out, Sally the Girl Scout forgot to bring the firewood, so she tossed her blank onto the fire.
Bra.
Tossed her bra. Okay. She said bra, Clifton.
Well, that's a perfectly normal, liberated woman or man's answer. Bra or undies, I said.
Okay, there's one for you. Score is 5-2 at this moment. You need 3 more to tie. Brett?
Huh? Hi, hon.
Hello, darling. You're
up. It's nice to be here. I'm thrilled.
Good.
Well, I figured a bra would go psh, and you wouldn't be able to even roast a marshmallow or cook a hot dog or anything. I said she threw on something that would last for a while and keep warm. A scout leader.
Throw on a scout leader. Gotta match your remaining 3 to achieve a tie, Cheryl. Do not be unruly.
You want to see a middle-aged
woman cry? Or you're gonna get thrown out. Charles.
Yeah.
Well, she was 9 years old, and so the bra didn't go, psh.
Where'd it go?
It was a training bar. It went, psh. I mean, forget about it. Badges.
Through the badges. All right, so Gary wins again. Thank you, Gary. Okay, come on down, Gary. We congratulate you. Now, you stand by here for a moment or so while we talk to Cheryl. Thank her for being with us.
Thank you.
You're a sweet-looking lady. We wish you the best of luck here. And we've got gifts for you. Cheryl Betters, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye. While she's spinning off, we'll spin these messages just for you. Here we are. Are you ready?
Ready.
Okay. It's time now for this big money super match where you can win over $10,000. Now, to do that, we have two audience matches for you. I want to remind you, whatever you win in these audience matches, you'll have a chance to multiply by 10. Here we go with the first one. We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Blank Lion. Now, the answer that group gave most frequently is worth $500 to you if you match it. Now, if you match the second most frequently given response, you get $250. The third gets you $100. Now, you want a little help?
Yeah, please. Patty?
Oh, Leo the Lion.
Leo the Lion?
Richard?
The Wind and the Lion. Movie just came out.
The Wind and the Lion. Okay.
Clifton.
You got one, Cliff?
Yeah, I got two.
You have?
Yeah. But I think instead of the cowardly, I'm going with... I shouldn't. Dandelion.
Dandelion? So you got Dandelion, Leo the Lion, and Wind in the Lion. You want one of those? You may have a better idea.
Leo.
You want Leo? Okay. That's the one that Patty gave you. Leo the Lion. He used to be a lion. I used to do years ago called The Part of Leo the Lion was played by Billy the Wolf. I don't do those lions anymore. Okay, and you know why. Okay, we are looking for Leo the Lion. Let's see if he's under the $100 number. Sea lion. Okay, I didn't think of that. Did you think of that?
No.
Okay. Let's see if Leo the Lion is under the $250 number. Cowardly lion. You thought of that. You didn't say it.
I started to say it.
Yeah. Okay. Here is the last chance for Leo the Lion. May we see the $500 number? You got $500. It means at least you'll be playing for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. That's the smallest you can win or play for here. Now let's see how you do with the second one. All right, Earl, slide it. Tim Blank. Tim Blank. All right, again, our celebrities are permitted to assist.
Patty.
Patty?
Oh, I didn't have time to think. Tim Conway.
Tim Conway. A funny fellow indeed.
Wonderful. Yeah.
Rich, or Charles, rather.
Charles.
Tim.
You got me, huh? It's
Tim Blank.
Tim.
Oh!
Tim?
Oh!
What?
Oh! We have notice how I don't lose my cool right in the camera.
Tim?
I got it. Watch, baby. Watch how I do it. Timbuktu.
Timbuktu. Okay.
Richard.
Present.
When he says present.
Tim Tiny.
No.
What if you read Christmas Carol backwards?
No. Come on.
That's why he was in the army.
Yeah. Oh, Tim Holt. One of my favorites.
Tim Holt.
A wonderful old person.
Tim Holt?
Let's not forget the oldest.
Even I didn't think Tim Holt.
So you got Tim Holt, Tim Conway, and Tim Buckdo. Now you can have one of those, or something that might have occurred to you.
I think Timbuktu.
Wait just a minute. What would you have said? Conway. They would have said Tim Conway. I don't want to make it feel bad, but they're usually right. No, not necessarily. Let's see if Timbuktu is under the $100 number. Tim McCoy. There's another oldie.
Played by Tim Holt.
Tim Holt played his part every time. Timbuktu is what we want. Is it under the $250 number? It is. Congratulations.
Charles, baby.
Just Charles.
That's nothing.
Okay. Well, there
Tim
it is.
Tim Conway, right?
Now, I'm curious to see. Tim Holt. They're probably right. It's either Tim Holt or Tim Conway, I'm sure of that. Tim Conway. All right, Earl, what a rip.
How quickly did I forget?
Okay. Anyway, Gary, you've won another $250. Multiply that by 10, makes $2,500. Add that to the previous $5,000, you got a pot of $7,500 to shoot for. Now, to collect that, you got to match one celebrity exactly. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay, Richard. Here it is. You want to swing around here?
I hope Tim Holt.
And face Mecca. And I'll get the $7,500 number.
Fort blank. That's F-O-R-T blank. Fort blank. All right. Gary, I hope your ESP is going right over there to Richard Dawson. Because if it is and it works, you'll be $7,500 richer. How do you fill in that blank to match him? Fort
Knox.
You're not sure of it, huh?
I got it.
Are there any other forts going through your mind, eh?
Fort Disaster, but...
Fort Disaster? Well, I hope it's not a disaster. We'll find out right now. Let's face our accuser here. He says Fort Knox will match you for $7,500. What do you say?
Well, you must remember that I gave you Tim Holt. He was in a film called Fort Apache, which was a very good film.
Fort Apache?
Yeah, very good.
Yes.
So please forgive me.
No. Oh, oh.
Grand total of $8,250. Okay. Well, while he's celebrating, we'll pass along these messages to you, and he'll be very happy. And a boy. Oh, listen, come over here. Congratulations to you once again, $8,250. Join us next week for the
Bill Todman production.